What's happening, good people? Welcome to the channel. I'm Wes, aka Mr. Budget Watch, and today I'm going to be showing you five of my picks for the best field watches that I've tried under, I think, about £400. So we're going to start from the least expensive to the most expensive. These will be linked in the description as well, all the links that you need. So there'll be review links if there is any, and also the links you can actually pick these watches up from. So let's start off with the cheapest first, and this is the Redeal. So this is a homage to the Seiko SNZ. It does not come on this strap, it comes on a different one, but the other strap got a little bit ruined, so I'll put it on this new one. So this watch will set you back around £12, and it is very impressive. I use this as a beta watch. I've used it for decorating, for like painting, for doing gardening, and just doing general everyday chores, and it is held up so well. I have like washed this under the sinks, it got covered in paint. You know, I've got mud all over it, grass, you know, all sorts of sort of plaster, wood filler, you know, poly filler, loads of stuff, and it is still in remarkable condition. I've dropped it, I've like hit it with stuff, and you know, not on purpose obviously, but it has held up really well. I honestly cannot believe it. I actually paid under £10 because I got this in a sale. I've had it about a year actually now, and this is my sort of go-to, you know, watch for doing everyday tasks. And you know what, for £10, I love the finish on it. It's like a sandblasted finish, got a mineral crystal, a good quality quartz movement, and you know what, it is really, really good, and it's surprisingly comfortable on this elastic NATO as well. The, you know, the stock strap was really terrible, but putting it on this one is really good. I actually wear it on a NATO strap for doing working, and that's like absolutely caked in paint and stuff. But yeah, this is a fantastic little beta watch. If you're not sure what a beta watch is, if you're like new to the hobby, a beta watch is essentially a watch you can wear without the fear of it breaking or damaging. And this is perfect. You know, if you break this, it's £10. It's not like more expensive like the rest on this list. So if you're looking for an ideal watch, you know, to do DIY gardening, etc. in, this is one I can highly recommend because it's so versatile, really comfortable, and it's pretty tough too. So yeah, that's my number one pick for, say, under £20. Next on this list is this one. So this is the Loris Titanium. They also do this in a steel version with a full loomed dial. Well, a loomy bright dial. If you want to check that out, I'll try and link that one in the description as well. It's basically the same watch, just with a steel case instead of titanium and better quality loom. I think both of them are around the same price. They're a little bit hard to come by new, but you can pick them up used quite readily. This is not the stock strap. I actually put this on a this elastic one from AliExpress. The stock strap isn't very good, to be fair. It's not great quality, and yeah, as soon as I got this watch and was done with the review, it went straight onto this one, and it is so much more comfortable, and it is super lightweight as well, with it being titanium. So again, if you've got a bit of a higher budget and want a beta watch, you know, that can do the same as this, but you want something maybe a little bit more premium, a little bit lighter, then you know, this is a great quality watch, and I'm very, very impressed with it. I mean, of course it's not perfect, none of the watches on this list are perfect, but it's good. It's got decent loom, really nice and legible with that cream and black dial, little date window, you know, screw down case back, very, very lightweight, like I said, with it being titanium. So yeah, this is definitely a great field watch, you know, to get you started, or if you're looking for a really lightweight, everyday sort of beta watch, if you've got a little bit more of a generous budget than the Redeal. So that's a really great pick. So next up, this is the Seiko SNK 807. So this is another cracking little field watch. I recommended this one to get you started in this hobby, and I'm still going to stand to that. If you're looking to get into collecting watches, this is a fantastic place to start. It's really compact at 37 millimeters, small lug to lug, that really nice sandblasted finish. Again, I've put it on a different strap because, like the Loris, the strap quality is not very good. So I did swap it out and it is so much better on this one. I've actually got another couple of straps coming for this as well. But yeah, very, very good quality watch. You can see it is an automatic Seiko 5, you know, really reliable. It's got an S726 movement in it, which is the same movement as the SKX. Day-date complication, crown at the fore. We've also got an exhibition style case back, which I'll just show you there so you can see the movement inside. The only thing that lets this watch down is the 30 meters of water resistance. So that means, you know, you're not going to want to like wash the dishes or, you know, do anything near water with this watch because it could potentially get ruined. That is this watch's Achilles heel, the 30 meters. It definitely should have had 50. So yeah, a little bit of a downside, but obviously if you keep this away from water, then you're absolutely fine. In the rain, you know, you're fine. In the shower, you know, on the right strap, you could probably get away with it, no problem. But yeah, the water resistance is this watch's biggest problem, but that's easily overcome if you don't have any water. So yeah, really fantastic choice. This one will set you back between 60-ish to under 100, depending on where you purchase it from. So it's a great little entry-level automatic watch. Next on this list is the Hamilton Corky Quartz. Now, you don't have to necessarily buy this exact model, because it's quite hard to come by now, and it is pretty expensive if you do buy it brand new. I got mine used off eBay, paid under £200 for it, and I absolutely love it. It's an absolutely stunning watch, one of my favourite in the collection. So this one again is a really nice field watch, obviously from the Corky range. Like I said, there are plenty of other styles and variations. The Corky range is absolutely enormous. It is a massive, massive range of watches. They've got quartzes, they've got automatics, and they've got mechanicals, all with their own pros and cons. You know, quartz is great for grab and go. Mechanical gives you a really long longevity. And then your automatics are just really, really impressive as well. Good power reserve and very, very high quality movements inside of them. So the reason why I love this one is because it's very versatile in my opinion. If you put this on a NATO strap, it looks very, very sporty. But if you put it on the right leather strap, then it looks quite elegant, which is something, you know, most other field watches can't. So say if I put, you know, this one, for example, on a leather, it wouldn't look nowhere near as elegant as this one. So this is like, it's a bit very, I wouldn't call it a unicorn, but it's very rare that you have a field watch that you can sort of dress down on a NATO and it'll look sporty, and then you can dress up. Now, there are other watches that you can do that with, but not so much field watches, which is why I love this one. I've got it on a leather strap at the minute. It's not the most elegant of leather straps, but it's really comfortable on this strap. And that's this watch's strong suit comfort, because it's got such a nice curvy profile. It is so, so comfortable. Super slim as well. Very, very nice. It's not perfect though. Mine doesn't hit its markers properly. But yeah, you know, yeah, you get over it eventually. Nice screw down case back. Yeah, really, really impressed with this. Again, I'll link it down in the description if you're interested. Loads of people comment on this every time, you know, I post it on Instagram and stuff. Yeah, wanting to know what the reference number is. So yeah, very, very beautiful and well made, well finished Swiss entry level quartz watch. And then finally, probably the best field watch in my opinion, under £400. Now you can actually buy these even cheaper, but they're off the grey market. You don't get the same warranty. Sellers can be a little bit iffy. So you always do your research if you're looking at one of these watches. I got mine off eBay, paid £225 for it, and it is immaculate. It barely even looks like it's been worn. And yes, it does work, it's just needs a wind. So you can see just giving it a wind and it should start working. And what I like about this watch as well, it's got an overwind protection. So you can actually feel when it's getting full, the crown will actually start giving you resistance, telling you it's done. So yeah, very, very beautiful. I've got it on this single pass strap. It's blue with like a faux patina color, which it, because it matches you know, the little triangles for the indices. And this one has been my dream Hamilton for a long time. I actually wanted it before I bought this Hamilton, but I didn't have the money at the time, and I just really, really wanted a Hamilton, so I bought this one. And then when this came up for the price, I just couldn't miss it. I sold a few watches, so I was able to afford it. And yeah, I absolutely love it. It come on a watch steward strap. Wasn't a fan of that. It was like green and red, didn't really go with the watch, so I put it on this one instead. I love that sandblasted finish, drilled lugs. Again, you know, the water resistance isn't amazing, but I am not putting this anywhere near water. Yeah, this is a perfect everyday field watch. It's super legible, and I love the white dial. It's the only white dial watch in my entire collection. So this one has a massive power reserve too, 80 hours, which is ridiculous. I think it's the, is it the H70 or H80 mechanical movement? Really, really good quality mechanical movement from Hamilton. Really, really impressive. Super compact as well. I think it's a 38 and 47 lug to lug. You can check the review for the proper sizes and everything that you need to know. But yeah, such a beautiful, again, got that really nice curved profile. And Hamilton do profiles really well. You can just see how nice and curvy they are. Again, you can show you that one. And it just makes for such a comfortable wearing watch. And it is so lightweight as well. Because it's mechanical, you know, it doesn't have a rotor in it. And again, because it doesn't have a rotor, it is super thin. Got that nice crystal on it. The only downside to this watch, I would say, is the water resistance is not very good. And the lack of AR coating on the crystal. Now, Hamilton have done this to keep it more vintage, like the watch is. I think a little bit of a clear AR coating underneath that crystal wouldn't have hurt, and it would definitely have made it a little bit more legible in some situations. But other than that, I absolutely love it. It's like my perfect watch, as you'll have seen by my review where I called it my perfect watch. Is it a perfect watch? No. Is it my perfect watch? Yeah. So anyway, they are my picks, and what I'll do is I'll you know, show them yet again for one final time all together. Just so you can see what we're looking at. So I'll just pan the camera down. Oh, they've all gone to the side, so sorry about that. So, you know, mechanical, you can pick these up sub 400. I wouldn't pay more than 250 for one of them in mint condition. Brand new, you're looking quite expensive, so look used. These ones, you know, 60-ish to under 90. Do not pay more than like 80 quid though for one of them brand new. I'll find a cheap place where you can get them from. Those ones is about 30, 40. Those don't pay more than like 15 to 18 quid. You can get them cheaper in the sale. So yeah, they are my top picks for field watches under £400. So I'll probably do this one, you know, this same video again in a year's time after I've got some more reviews under my belt. But these are my top picks that I've had for a long time. I've had plenty of experience with all of them, and I can highly recommend each and every one of these, depending on your budget. So, which one would you guys pick down in the comments? Let me know. Thanks for watching the video. Be sure to subscribe if you haven't already. Like the video if you enjoyed it. Hit that notification bell so you don't miss any uploads. And of course, follow me on social media at Mr. Budget Watch. Thanks again. I'll see you soon.